You might think your hair and eye color are permanent, but in reality, they could change at any time. And it definitely already changed once. Greetings, programs. Trace here for DNews. Many babies are born with blue eyes, and then their eyes change color as their genes continue to develop. Hair color is the same way. Sometimes babies are born with very light-colored hair, which gradually darkens. We've got a few questions on this, so we did some digging. The colored part of the eye is the iris. It controls how much light is let into the eyeball, and its color is determined by melanin, just like skin and hair. Darker colors absorb more light, and lighter colors reflect more. Color is determined by a few different genetic factors, the most important being OCA2. OCA2 produces melanocytes, or melanin-producing cells. Melanin is the protein that creates skin, eye, and hair color. More melanin means darker eyes, hair, or skin. The color of the melanin in the eyes is determined by three other genes, EYCL1, 2, and 3. Together, they account for brown, green, or blue eyes, but not hazel or gray eyes. Science is still working on how we get to those. All blue-eyed people can trace their ancestry back to a single human born between 6 and 10,000 years ago near the Black Sea. Due to a genetic mutation, a human was born with a tiny switch right before that OCA2 gene. That limits the expression of the melanin, kind of like diluting the stream of the protein. Individuals with albinism, or albinos, have the OCA2 gene completely shut off so that their skin, eyes, and hair have no melanin at all. With all this in mind, let's apply it to babies. When we're born, our genetics are decided, but the body hasn't necessarily acted on all the genes in your DNA. When it comes to eye color, the melanin controlled by the OCA2 gene is diluted, and thus we all have blue eyes. Well, Caucasians usually. For those with that blue eye gene mutation, their eyes stay blue. But for the vast majority of us, once we're born, the OCA2 gene kicks into gear, creating melanocytes to make proteins, and the eyes turn a different color. Somewhere between 9 months and 2 years after birth, it'll start to set. A medium amount of the melanin makes green eyes or hazel eyes, and a large amount makes them brown. With regard to hair, the melanin builds up the same as in eyes, creating a dark color. As babies age, their melanin levels increase, and their hair will darken. Hair colors can also change well into puberty, as some genes aren't even switched on until those hormones flood the body during adolescence. Eventually, usually in the 30s, human hair stops producing melanin altogether and starts turning gray. Basically, it stops adding color to the hair. Gray hair tends to occur earlier in Caucasians and later in Asians. It's important to point out that not all babies, again, are born with blue eyes. It mainly occurs with Caucasian babies, maybe because of the lower levels of overall melanin in their body due to the lighter skin tone. Babies of Asian, African, and Hispanic genetic heritages will likely be born with dark eyes that stay dark. Funnily enough, 10 to 15% of Caucasians report their eye color continued to change into adulthood, so it's possible that your peepers are still not settled. So what's your favorite eye color? What do you wish you had? Tell us in the comments and make sure you subscribe to DNews for more science. We are here twice a day, every day of the year. Do you have questions? Let us know on Twitter at DNews or come find me at Trace Dominguez. Thanks so much for watching. Catch you next time.